That's really scary. I can't imagine having anything like that happen to us.
Yeah, let's hope that never comes somewhere near us. So let's review today's show.
The PHS softball team is hosting their second annual Strikeout for Cancer game on May 1st.
Remember to sign up for tennis.
Be sure to turn in your library books soon.
Finally, your feedback is important to our team, so if you have any questions, concerns, or something you want to do on the show, email us at ptv2@plymouth.k12.in.us.
That does it for us today. If you want more incredible Red Storm news, sports, and weather, go to ljhdigitalstorm.com.
Today's show is brought to you by Van Giller Funeral Home, here to comfort you in a time of extreme need.
See you tomorrow.
Bills on my mindset, I can't deny it. Getting higher than my income. Income's breadcrumbs, I've been trying to survive. The glow that the sun gets right around sunset helps me realize this is just a journey. Drop your worries, you are gonna turn out fine. Oh, you turn out fine.
Good afternoon, Lincoln. Today we have a spectacular show lined up for you. I'm Clay, the anchor for today, along with my co-anchor Matt. We're ready to give you the best news that Plymouth has to offer.
Coming up on Lincoln's Daily News,
the PHS softball strikeout cancer game,
extra autism awareness shirts are available,
Lincoln sports results,
a PTV 2 special report, and so much more. So sit tight and we'll be right back in 45 seconds.
My hands in my pockets, kicking these rocks. It's kind of hard to watch this life go by. I'm buying into skeptics. Skeptics mess with the confidence in my eyes. I'm seeing all the angles, thoughts get tangled. I start to compromise. My life and my purpose, is it all worth it? Am I gonna turn out fine? Oh, you turn out fine. Fine. Oh, you turn out fine. You gotta keep your head up, oh, and you can let your head down, hey, you gotta keep your head up, oh.
And we're back in Studio One in Lincoln Junior High School in Plymouth, Indiana.
Here are today's top stories.
Today started our last round of iStep. Computers will be collected in the max time rooms at 3 o'clock. If you did not bring your charger today, you be sure to bring it tomorrow so your computer does not die.
Wanting to do something extra to help with autism awareness? Buy a shirt for only $12. $5 of every shirt stays in the building to help students with autism. We have sizes youth, medium, adult small, medium, large, and only two extra larges. Everyone can wear your t-shirts with jeans on Friday, May 1st. Make sure to turn your $12 into the office and checks made payable to Autism Resources of Marshall County.
Attention staff, looking for a way to get fit and have fun at the same time? The LifeLex is hosting an aqua boot camp. The camp will take place May 5th through June 11th on Tuesdays and Thursdays from 5:30 to 6:30 p.m. The cost is $80 if you are not a member and $70 if you are a member. The registration deadline is May 4th. Hurry up and get signed up to ensure a spot.
With the end of the year approaching faster than ever, and by the way, just in case you're counting, there are only 25 days left of the school year. We need to plan on turning our library books in soon. All materials are due back on Friday, May 15th. Make sure that you get those in so that Mrs. Day can close up and doesn't have to track you down.
As everyone knows here at Lincoln, we have LJH Reads. Every Wednesday, we read for our entire max time. But there's one problem. Some people forgot to bring books. Well, this is a simple way to fix that. Just read the school newspaper. This helps the people who write the paper and helps you if you forgot a book.
Do you have your favorite app? Do you have your favorite app game for your mobile device? Of course you do. You actually think your teachers believe you're on your phones during schoolwork? Ha!
Well, PTV2 decided to take a look into this fascinating world of video gaming on our phones to find out what your favorite games are. Take a look at what we found.
Candy Crush.
Extreme Car Simulator 2015.
Clash of Clans.
Zigzag.
Hi, welcome back to our new segment called What's Hot and What's Not.
This week on What's Hot and What's Not,
we will be looking at the top 5 most played games in our school.
We have gone around interviewing students from Lincoln and asking them what their most played game is on their device.
At the end, we will total up the data and let you know what the top 5 video games are played.
Before we interviewed Lincoln Junior High students, we made a guess of what the top 5 games would be.
Number 1 was Clash of Clans.
Number 2 was Zigzag.
Number 3 was Candy Crush.
Number 4 was Crossy Road.
And number 5 was Minecraft.
Now let's get to the actual result.
Thanks for watching this week's special segment. Stay tuned for next week's show.
Okay, I saw a game or two that I know I'm guilty of playing once in a while. How about you, Clay?
Yeah, me too. Especially Clash.
Well, we have no birthdays here at Link LJH today, but it is the famous Jessica Alba's birthday. Happy birthday from all of us here at PTV2 at Lincoln.
Now it's time to talk about our most incredible Red Storm sports, weather, and lunch. What's going on, Olive?
Quite a bit is happening, but before I start with our sports and lunch today, I'd like to give a shout out to our sponsor, Coca-Cola, where your taste buds go wild after one sip. Attention Lincoln tennis players. The Plymouth Tennis Club is having sign-ups. People 11 and older can sign up by contacting Michael Delp and getting a paper or virtual form. If you are interested in this opportunity, contact Michael Delp at the high school. Sign-ups are Monday, May 4th and Tuesday, May 5th from 4 to 7 p.m. at the courts in Centennial Park. On Wednesday, there will be a 7th and 8th grade girls golf meet at the Plymouth Country Club at 4:30. They will be facing Warsaw. Also on Wednesday, there will be a 7th and 8th grade track meet here at Lincoln at 5, facing off Uri and New Prairie. Good luck, Lincoln! This Friday, the PHS softball team will be hosting its second annual Strikeout Cancer Game. The entire game is a pink out to partner with Ounce of Prevention. If anyone wants to buy a pink t-shirt, they are $10 each. You can do so by contacting Haley Church. For each $10, $5 of those dollars will be given to an Ounce of Prevention. T-shirts can be picked up Thursday and worn to school on Friday. For Wednesday's lunch, we will be having mini corn dogs with some fresh cuts of prime meat, awesome baked beans, garden salad straight from Olive Garden, some awesome Cheez-Its with fabulous fruit, and some of the best cow milk ever. Enjoy your lunch, Lincoln. Taking a look out the weather window, there will be a high of 62 and a low of 43 today. The rest of the week seems pleasant, so make sure you get outside and have some fun. Again, a big thanks to our sponsor, Coca-Cola, where you drink the most cooling drink in the summer. Now back to our anchors, Clay and Champ. What's up, guys?
Thanks, Olive!
For our current event today, we take a look at a wacky tourism claim that South Dakota is better than Mars.
That's weird. That's a weird way to attract attention.
You can say that again.
Let's take a look.
People signed up to take a one-way trip to Mars. You know about this? That's people who want to go there despite the lack of survivable conditions. Now, in a new tourism pitch, one state says it can do you one better.
Mars. The air.
not breathable. The surface, cold and barren. But thousands are lining up for a chance to go and never come back. South Dakota, progressive, productive, and abundant in oxygen. Why die on Mars when you can live in South Dakota? South Dakota.
I think it's brilliant.
Oh,
I think it's fantastic. South Dakota releasing that tongue-in-cheek ad trying to lure some would-be Martians.
I love it. And abundant oxygen.
The problem is by the time they see that spot on Mars,
yeah, exactly.
It'll be millions of years old.
Wow, I think South Dakota really is better than Mars.
I have to agree with you on that one, champ. So let's review today's show.
The PHS softball team is hosting their second annual Strikeout for Cancer game on May 1st.
Remember to sign up for tennis.
Be sure to turn in your library books soon. The library needs all materials by May 15th.
Finally, your feedback is important to our team. If you have a question, concern, or something you want on the show, email us at ptv2@plymouth.k12.in.us.
That does it for us today. If you want more incredible Red Storm sports, weather, and lunch, just go to ljhdigitalstorm.com.
Today's show was brought to you by Coca-Cola. Have a Coke and have a smile.
See you right back here tomorrow.
Yeah.